Mathieu Eugene, who will also present a proclamation to Dr. Jeffrey God here at this time.
Thank you very much, Michael. Thank you so very much. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
I'm going to be very, very brief because I know that you are eager to listen, to hear, you know, great doctor, Dr. Jeff. And I am too. My name is Mathieu Eugene. And I'm a New York City Council member representing District 40, your district, the district where Downtown Medical Center is located. And I always say that I'm privileged and blessed to have this great institution in my district, the district I'm privileged to serve. This great institution that I provide, that is providing state-of-the-art medical care to the people in Brooklyn, and New York City, and beyond. And I want to take the opportunity to thank all the wonderful people from the Downtown Medical Center for the wonderful job that they are doing. And I'm proud of you. Thank you so very much for all of you. It is a good honor for me to join you today as we celebrate Black History Month and take a moment also to pay tribute to many of us who have made a tremendous contribution. You know them. One of them is Martin Luther King Jr., Rosa Parks. And now we can say that New York City is also better because of Dr. Jeff. Now, 50 years or 100 years after, the generation, the next generation, will have to mention the name of Dr. Jeff for his tremendous contribution to the well-being of our community. And as you know, he's not only working to impact or to help the people in Brooklyn overcome the difficulties, the challenges, but also he was instrumental to bring relief to my Haitian brothers and sisters in Haiti when Haiti was hit by several tropical storms, earthquakes, and several natural disasters. And for that, on my behalf, and also on behalf of all of you, because I know you have been there for the Haitian people too, and on behalf of all my Haitian brothers and sisters, to Dr. Jeff, thank you so very much. Now, it is my honor to be able to present Dr. Jeff with a proclamation from this great city of New York. Thank you very much for this warm introduction. Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Mathieu Eugene, and I'm a New York City Council member representing District 40. That means where you are at right now. And I say that all the time. I feel blessed and fortunate to have this wonderful, remarkable, historic institution in the district that I'm privileged to serve. I'm talking about Downtown Medical Center. And I would be remiss if I didn't take the opportunity to thank Dr. Casey.
Thank you.
And all the great members of the staff, all the professionals, doctors, nurses, and technicians who are working day in and day out to make Downtown Medical Center such a wonderful institution. Not only in Brooklyn and New York, in the state of New York, and also in the United States. Thank you so very much for everything that you do, every single day for my constituents, for New Yorkers, and beyond. Thank you very much. You know, today I have two very important public hearings in the City Council. The first one is going to start at 10 o'clock. But I say to myself, I have to come over here. Because this is such a very important forum, very important meeting. And I say that I have to come to thank all the organizers,
Down to Medical Center, all the speakers and all the organization, and I know we have some organization also from the federal, state, and city organization. Thank you so very much to all of you. Let's put our hands together for them, please. Thank you. It is important because being prepared is so important, especially now, because you know that New York City is a target, regardless of whatever we may think. But in addition to that, natural disasters, you don't know where they come. And you don't know what the extent is going to be. And it is very important that we get prepared. Not only we get prepared, we are prepared, but we educate also the people, the constituent, the citizen, for them to know exactly what to do in case of a disaster, natural disaster. No one can forget Sandy. What we saw in Sandy tells us clearly that we are vulnerable. We have to do more to be prepared to save lives, because if you are prepared, not only will you be able to save lives, to decrease the damage, and also to facilitate, to make the relief effort easier. You know, I was born and raised in Haiti. And you know, Haiti has been struck by many natural disasters. And what makes it worse for Haiti is because they were not prepared. They don't have any, you know, emergency preparedness institution. And that's the reason why I started speaking with many of my partners, like Dr. Casey, and many doctors and other professionals at Downstairs Medical Center, to help me create a permanent emergency service or institution here. I'm going to conclude by saying that what you are doing here today is very important for every single citizen or person in New York City. It is very important for them to know exactly what to do when they are facing emergency. If they don't know, it's going to be catastrophe, you know that. And I want to let you know that I'm willing to work with you, and I'm willing to partner with you to see what my office can do to bring a little contribution, whatever we can do, in the wonderful task that you are trying to accomplish. And again, to all of you, thank you so very much. Thank you not only on my behalf, but on behalf of the people of the great city of New York. Thank you, God bless you.
The stage that we're in, the construction is, they've finished the two required levels of shielding, the RF and the magnetic. So they've finished the walls and the floor. Next is they're doing the seating. So after this, we're going to have it tested for any leakage, and then we'll pass it. And after that, the next is we bring in the exhaust ducts and the cryogen. And we'll complete that, and then we're ready to bring in the next month, right, Gino, yes. The machine itself. So that's where we are. We've progressed this far.
Right.
So
it's a 3T.
3T, 3T.
That's exactly what I was going to ask. This is a brilliant explanation, but the people who are watching, they are wondering what he's talking about. You said it was going to be a machine. What type of machine?
It's a 3T MRI. It's okay. It's the most powerful machine right now. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, for regular clinical studies, that's what we use.
Wow.
Thank you.
I'm so pleased and delighted, so honored to be a little piece of your team.
You're a major piece.
You are doing tremendous work, great job every single day. Saving people's life, and this is a good asset to not only to my district, but to the city of New York. But honestly, I don't see the most powerful words, what I can say to thank you for what you are doing.
I mean, thank you. I mean, Danny, when was the last time we had a second MRI? It's been a number of years, right?
Yeah,
over 10 years since we had a second MRI.
Over 10 years,
you know, so it was taken away. And then we had the funding to get another MRI, but you know, thanks to your office, we were able to get the second MRI. It's been over 10 years. Right. So in the past, this MRI goes down. We really have no way to go.
Wow.
Now we'll have the flexibility of having two MRIs in case one goes down, we'll have, you know, to be able to ship the patients here.
So. You know who I want to benefit from that? The community. The hardworking people, our workers, you know, the models, farmers, the citizen of my district, the citizen of New York City. And let me say that, and my colleagues and all of you know what I'm talking about. They are hardworking people who pay, who are paying taxes. They are entitled to the services. And then they have the right to stay healthy. And we have the moral obligation to provide them, you know, the best quality of medical care. And that's the reason why I am advocating in the city council. And I put it in front of my colleagues already. I said, you know, hospital, and medical services, medical centers should be on the top of our priorities.
Right.
Believe it or not, if you don't have health, I say that all the time, it doesn't matter how poor or rich you are, but then you can. And I pledge, you know, for this budget situation, I'm going to fight to make sure that in the city council, we allocate more funding to the hospital. Because, come on, it's a win-win situation. Because when people are healthy, they work hard, they contribute to the society, they have a strong community. But when they are sick, everybody's in trouble. And again, I want to give the opportunity to change the world.
Thank you.
Started with the CT scan, direct replacement, we were in an MRI, and this is a new PET CT machine. So that was relocated to give way to the MRI project, so we moved it here. So I think what we used to have was just a strictly PET. Now this is a PET CT combination.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we just put up the wall the other day.
You put the wall up there.
So we'll invite you back, you know, definitely once everything is in place, just to show you the investment that you made into the hospital. And so we're looking forward to it. So multiple projects, again, thanks to you, that we're becoming a really state-of-the-art facility with the technology that we have here. So it's really amazing. We could compete with any hospital here in the city.
I love it.
Absolutely.
Because, you know, I want people in Brooklyn to know that they're like two cool hospitals, good institution.
To all of you, good morning. Before I start speaking, let me just thank Francesca for this honor. But I'm just your humble servant. Just a member of the team. Thank you very much. You know, I don't have to tell you how happy, how delighted that I am to be here today. And every time that I have to come to King's County Hospital, I'm very happy. I don't want to come as a patient, honestly, all the love that I have for you, but I'm happy to be here. And I want to take the opportunity to thank first Mr. Enzo Baptiste for your leadership, for the tremendous work that you are doing, leading this very important medical institution. Thank you so very much. And I'm going to give you another reason why I want to thank you. And I want to thank also your wonderful staff, all of those wonderful people, day in and day out, who are working together with you to make King's County Hospital one of the best hospitals, not only in Brooklyn and New York, but also in the United States. Thank you so very much. And when I say thank you to you, all the members of this country, the hardworking people, what I want to thank also everybody, the doctors, the nurses, those in the administration, those who are, you know, doing the maintenance of the hospital. Because when I come over here, the place is so clean, so clean. So that it takes all the team to make this country such a wonderful. Please, also you know my commitment to advocate for you and to do everything that I can do for the city council to provide the resources that you have at all levels. But this morning I want to read a quote that made me so happy. thing that gave me more strength to fight and to advocate in the city council, you know, for all of you at Kings County. Let me read the quote, and you know, you want to see what I'm talking about. A judge of the Eastern District of New York agreed to end oversight of the hospital behavioral health program by the U.S. Department of Justice, which reported that the hospital performance has exceeded their expectation. You have demonstrated that you at Kings County Hospital, you have the skill, the expertise, and the dedication to fulfill the medical need of our patients and to make Kings County Hospital, as I said, one of the best hospitals in Brooklyn, in New York, and also in the United States. For that, all of you, thank you so very much. You make me proud. And also, you give me more power and more strength to fight for you. When I was in medical school, one of my teachers, or professor, said that everything is related in life. Everything. You see, the air is very important for human beings. If the air is not good, we are all going to be sick. So I'm saying the food we eat, everything. But talking about Kings County Hospital, we know that Kings County Hospital is a place that provides medical care to everyone, regardless of your immigration status and your ability to pay. This is the reason why also all of us from government, we have to do everything that we can do to support Kings County Hospital. But I would be remiss if I didn't take the opportunity also to acknowledge our assembly member, Wendy Bishop. Wendy, I'm very happy to see you. Thank you so very much for showing us. And also our former assembly member who now is working with the governor. Thank you so very much. Thank you so much. And to all of you from the state, thank you so very much, because it takes a team to succeed. I was talking about that everything is related. Kings County is a place that is providing medical care to everybody, including our immigrant people. But I want to say that today, or right now, many members of our community, they don't know what their life is going to be. They don't know what the future is going to be because of their immigration status. Every single day I got many people going to my office crying and trying to figure out what they have to do because of their immigration status. I want to thank you for the form that you are going to do, know your right for our immigrants. I have organized many of them, and I want to just to invite you and to ask you to share that with the people that you know that would need the information that will help them know exactly what they have to do in, with respect with their immigration status. On March 8th, that's on Wednesday, at Pier 6, we are going to have an immigration forum. We'll have many attorneys in immigration advocating for immigrants to provide not only information, but also services. New York City is home to so many Haitian people. Not only Haitian, many people from Haiti, from Trinidad, from Jamaica, from Pakistan. But Haitian people, they are facing a special challenge because most of them got TPS. TPS means temporary protected status. We don't know if the president is going to renew it. You know that, you know, the new government, the new administration, they are trying to terminate all the benefits that certain immigrants used to receive. The Haitian people TPS is set to expire on July 22nd. So we from the community, members from the community, elected officials, we are doing the effort to ask and to urge the president to renew the TPS. I just want to let you know that there's a petition online to ask the President of the United States and Homeland Security to renew the TPS suffragation, because if they don't renew the TPS, there are 50,000 Haitian people who may face deportation. Please, I'm asking you for your support for the Haitian community. You can go online on www.httpsrenewal.com. Let me conclude by saying that every time that I come here, I come with something. I come with something. Because I know that to do the job, you need something. You need support and you need resources. But I want to mention also that the funding that I was able to secure for you and to provide you, every single day I see the result. Every time that I come over here, I see the result. As a matter of fact, as I speak, a good friend of mine and a good friend of Francisca also is right now hospitalized in this center. She went through brain surgery. And as a matter of fact, after this, first I'm going to see her. So this is another way to see that I thought it is for me and for my coalition government to provide resources that this Nancy hospital needs to save people. Her life was saved because of you guys. And for that, thank you so very much. Now let me take the opportunity to present a little token of appreciation, a little check. Today is not to be. It is very small. I'm pleased to present Mr. Battis for King's County Hospital, a check of $1,494,000.
Dr. Eugene is a member of the New York City Council 40th District. He is a passionate healthcare advocate for his constituents and for the patients of New York City Health and Hospitals, Queens County. I can actually stand here and say that no one has supported this hospital more than Dr. Eugene. He not only helped us get a linear accelerator, but that big magnet, the big MRI that everyone's been talking about for the past week that just got installed, that's the only one in Brooklyn, Dr. Eugene. So thank you so much, Dr. Eugene. So together with the Brooklyn delegation and New York State elected officials, he has secured millions of dollars in funding for Kings County. So without further ado, please come up, Dr. Eugene, and thank you again.
Thank you so very much, Annika, Wendy. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm going to be very, very brief. But my name is Mathieu Eugene, and I'm the New York City Council member representing District 40. That means the district where this great institution, Kings County Hospital, is located. District 40. They always say that I'm a very blessed and fortunate person. And this morning, I am very delighted, and it is a great honor for me to join you to pay tribute and to show appreciation, to show gratitude to the doctors, and they deserve it. Put your hands together for all of them, please. You know, the doctors, they are making sacrifices to take care of human beings from the beginning of life to the end of life. Every human being, regardless of who you are receiving services from doctors. If you didn't do that in your life, when you were born, the first people you get in contact with are the doctors. Doctors, I just want to, on behalf of the community, on behalf of the people in Brooklyn, on behalf of the people in the state of New York, on my own behalf, and from the bottom of my heart, I want to tell you, I appreciate what you have been doing every single day. And I want to tell you that you are doing God's work. And thank you for that. Thank you. I know this is not easy, because doctors are also human beings. Regardless of your challenges, regardless of your family challenges, you want to make sure that your patient comes first. And you have been doing everything possible to make sure you get back them back to health, and you get them back also to their family. And again, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. And you are my motivation to advocate for the best quality of care for the people that I'm serving. God bless you. Thank you.
It's really very modern. It's a much smaller, it fits in terrace, because always in an ICU room, you know, there's not a lot of room, because a lot of the doctors look like they look at pre-medication, post-medication, and they can keep track of all that. In addition, the nurses really like this one, because when they leave the room, it's really hard to see the numbers from outside. So they can actually move the screen. It has full mobility. It can go up and down for their height, and they can put this towards the window so they can see what's going on with the patient at all times. If an alarm goes off the block where the alarm comes from, if it's a high pressure or if their respiratory rate's high, that will light up. As well, the doctors really, a lot of times we can't always convey information to the doctors. We can write down numbers, we can tell them what happened, but there's nothing like a picture to tell you the true story, right? So we have here, I just did that, we have here under media, I took a picture of a before and after loop. Now this means nothing to do, but to the doctors, this is gold. They'll be able to see how the medication's working, so I can do, this is how the patient's numbers were beforehand, and this is how their graphics were beforehand. It's kind of like looking at an EKG, but by respiratory. And then they can look that the blue was beforehand and the white's after, so they can really gather information on this. They can drag this information into place, and those will be the first things you see. So it's very easy to get information out. It's very easy to set up. This is all very easy to clean, which is very important these days with the Joint Commission. And it gives you tons of information for the doctors.
This is wonderful. This is remarkable, the size.
Yeah, the size. And it's nice.
It's very neat and very nice.
Everything's, you know, touchscreen.
The functional, so the features are that.
Yeah, it has a lot of really great features in it.
See all the great work that you're...
Oh, that's wonderful, wonderful. That's
because of you, we were able to achieve this. 20 new ventilators.
Listen, what you are doing in comparison of what I'm doing is nothing.
Okay.
This is only my way to encourage you and to say that, oh, guys, you know what? I love what you're doing, and keep on doing that.